Anyway, let's just explore the town a bit and see what's going on. It's been a while. Seeing if anything's changed since the last time we played this. And see if I can remember what I'm actually supposed to be doing.
I know that Corus and your father were old friends. That is why Corus has been taking good care of the village.
I don't remember who Corus is.
There is much you can learn from that man. Train hard under him.
Hey, welcome to the stream. I'm doing well, thank you. I had quite a good day at work today, so I'm quite happy.
We should seek out Kikinok, the legend.
Oh yes, we need to go to the Dragonfly Forest, that's right. That's the story the old man was telling us. Yeah, I'm having a good day. Had a good day at work. Just had a nice takeaway from my favourite takeaway, Kebab King.
Doing divine magic is very...
So I'm very content right now. Let's see if we have a good night of gaming ahead of us. And I'm also quite excited about YouTube as well. I released a podcast on Monday. Yesterday. I recorded it a while ago. But, yeah, it came out on Monday and I spoke a bit about my plans for the future and how I want to make this Everything You Know to Know series.
Who serve us.
Okay, good job. We can skip this. I don't want to hear it every time. So, actually, I can show you. I can show you the plans. I need to get a wireless controller. I don't know whether you can see that, but it was all tangled around my chair then. Right, one second, I'll show you this. It's pretty cool. I don't even know if you'll be able to see it properly, but if you listen to my podcast here... Yeah, but you can't see it. Kind of. Maybe? Let's try and go in on camera mode. I wasn't planning on showing this off, but... There you go. So I have a list on that side of all the consoles. And I have top games, hidden gems, history, memories, something else that I can't see because I need to look at the screen, but I can't look at the screen if I'm on the camera. Anyway, and I'm going through and ticking off all the videos and there's all the different systems going down the side there. And that was very awkward to show off. So yeah, where am I up to on GBA? Next one is a gems video. So look forward to that soon. Anyway, let's get back to the actual game. That's the plans anyway. I've got that up on the wall so I can tick them all off as I'm going. And before we start the stream, have a look down there. Can you see him? Can't see him. No, he's just outside of reach. Skittles. There he is. He's in here with me today. And I need to organise this room. It's a complete mess. Yeah, you can see him. Excellent. The HDMI cable is only just long enough. I'm surprised it still stayed attached. Right, anyway, we are trying to make some new creatures, I think. I'm just going to try and combine... What happens if you combine two of the same? Because we've got three of the same here. So, will that help? Let's try it. Anyway, Flaming Krieg, I'm glad that you had a good day at work too. And now hopefully you can also have a nice relaxing evening. Oh my god, auto moderation is pretty funny. Got another CIB game today. Came in a big package from Bayi. Oh god. I've been going a bit Bayi mad recently. What did you get today? I presume this, what I'm doing here, is actually going to be useful. Yeah, you're not allowed to talk about your big package on my stream. Yeah, I have a lot of stuff coming from Boye. Mostly Wonderswan things, which I'm quite excited for. Maybe I should give these a different name. Just so I know that they're actually new creatures. There we go. His name is now Patimel 2. He's only level 3 though. Let's see. 27, 28, 25 and 20. And he's still not as strong either. Oh well. Let's move on. Ah, maybe I should actually try and sell him. Oh well. I probably don't need to worry about it. At the minute, anyway. Let's just try going to the next stage. Or I guess to the blacksmith. Don't have to worry about Skittles eating my games. He's over there poking the shelf with all the SNES games on it. Can't see him because it's focusing on the microphone. He's just wandering around aimlessly. He'll settle down in a minute. Just oh, I haven't got any money. But that's alright, because there's not anything worth buying anyway. Why am I wasting my time here? I've been streaming for 10 minutes now and haven't made any progress. Oh, nice. What games are on that cave shooting collection? I'm a big fan of cave shooters. Alright, here we go, back to the Dragonfly Forest. Let's see if I can remember anything about it. Oh yeah, something interesting came the other day. If you can see this. There we go. This camera's awful at focusing. I need to get a better lens. There you go. It is Professor Henno Henno, which is what became Gunpei. It's the final game that Gunpei Yokoi ever made in 1997. And I actually won the other one of these. There is a second game as well, like a snake game. And I actually won that one on Boye, so that is coming as part of my big set of things from Boye coming very soon that I'm excited for. But yeah, I'm working on a Gunpei Yokoi history video, so that is going to play a prominent role in that video, because it's a very important piece of history. And I've also been working on an Akihabara history video as well. But maybe, yeah, that won't be for a while. I don't know where I'm supposed to be going. Let's just try going this way. I might do that actually, because I've got about 7 or 8 things coming at once. So maybe I could do some sort of like mystery Japanese games unboxing or something. It's pretty cool on Boye, you know, they've upgraded it to have loads of different websites on there. So I've found some cool stuff just by doing the same search on different sites. I forgot how slow these fights can be. This is what most of our evening's going to be, I think. Seven different items that I've consolidated into one package. So not seven different packages of games, that would be a bit much. I mean, that would be nice, but I'm not made of money, despite what people think. I just spend it all on games and nothing else. Right, let's try now. Oh god, yeah, hopefully customs don't catch me. They haven't done sometimes, so fingers crossed they'll pass me by. Have you ever got caught out by customs? Had to pay any fines or anything? Any import tax or duty tax, whatever it's called? Yay, it's always good if you get something and you don't get a letter from customs. Sometimes they send the letter after you've already received the items. And what would you do if I don't pay? I've already got them. You can't come and take them off us, can you? Yeah, I think Brexit might have made it more strict overall. Unfortunately. What am I looking for here? Valuables. Let's see what that knowledge thing was. While inflicted with sleep, you cannot act. Your physical and magical defense and avoidance ability decrease, resulting in more damage from attacks. Okay. Then I shall try not to fall asleep. I forgot how nice the graphics are. These graphics look amazing, don't they? So I'm supposed to be finding... I can't even remember. A winged man? I can't remember what the story was, and I listened to it twice last time as well. I took my socks off, and instantly the dog tries to eat them. Lie down. Can't trust him. They wanted an invoice for a buy package, and it wasn't included, so they had no idea what the value was. Haha, perfect. You can always just say it's junk, like how Japan classifies some stuff. It's worthless, it's just junk. No one wants these old games anymore. Estimated value zero. Belongs in a landfill, but don't take it there. I loved going around hard off in Japan into their junk section, and the stuff that Japan considers junk is definitely, like, even better quality than a lot of stuff that you'd find in, say, CX here in the UK. It's pretty crazy that they classify it as junk, and it's perfectly fine to us. But it's like pennies. I picked up a Wonderswan for 500 yen, I think, which is like £3, something like that, which is insane. Yes, my house is also a landfill. A landfill of pieces of gaming history. I mean, one day, if they were just sat here long enough, I suppose they would decompose. In like 100 years time. Yay, we captured something. I'm not sure if I'm doing the creature training thing right or not. It doesn't really seem to be... I don't really seem to be using the creatures that I've caught. They probably will, to be honest. Whether they'll actually work or not, though, I don't know, because this struggled to read the cartridge CD earlier. That's why I was a bit late on here, because it was coming up with that disc read error. Annoyingly. Maybe I should try bringing a monster out. Ooh, ouch. Okay, let's try. Sasenko. Is he here this time? He was in the last stream. I started naming the monsters after the people in the stream. It'll be like how Egyptians are buried with treasure. You'll just find a copy of Chrono Trigger in my grave. Unfortunately, I've already donated all my manga, so that can't be buried with me. That's all gone to a charity shop. I used to have loads of manga and I just found that I was never reading it. Which is a shame. Because I did used to enjoy reading manga. And I was talking to my girlfriend earlier about anime because she was watching some, and I figured out that the last proper anime series that I watched of my own accord was back in 2013. So I'm a little bit behind the times when it comes to any sort of weeb stuff. What manga did I have? I'd been enjoying reading a series called Terraformers, or Terraformars, which was cool. About a group of scientists who merged themselves with beetles so that they can survive on Mars or something? Or cockroaches, yeah, that's it. It was a very weird one. What else? I was also enjoying a series called Genshiken, I think? Which is like an otaku series about a group of people who are making doujin to sell at Comiket, which was really cool. I enjoyed seeing all like the history of Akihabara and stuff in there. And someone else recommended me another series similar to that called Comic Party, I think. Which is something else that I want to check out at some point. Oh, cool, you knew what that was. Nice, I don't know anyone who's heard of it. Lucky Star, obviously. I had Lucky Star. Bakuman, yeah. I read all of Bakuman. I actually started reading that back at uni when the first volume came out in the UK. I love that sort of... what would you even call that sort of manga? Like Genshiken or Bakuman? Like creative stories? Stories about creative people? That's why I think I'd enjoy Comic Party. And there was something else about a group of game developers as well. But that was a visual novel. I can't remember what it was called now, though. What else was I reading? There was one called Tagami Bachi, which is like some fantasy adventure where someone had to deliver some important parcels to different parts of the world and he'd find different things along the way. A tablet rests against a statue of a dragonfly. Magic usage 1 picked up. What is it? I thought that'd be where I find the man that I'm supposed to be going to. Let's see. Magic usage 1. Mana will recover slightly and damage is less likely while defending. Defend skillfully to boost your special attack and magic power. Ah, okay. I didn't realise that defence would actually build back up your magic, so that's good. Restore HP and mana. Maybe I should use that. Oh, that's only for minions. What about this? Is that for humans? No. Oh no, I've got nothing to heal my own health. Oh dear. I'm doomed. Jagan, what's that about? I don't really have any sort of preference, whether it's shonen, seinen. Even shoujo, I don't mind. When I first met my girlfriend, she introduced me to a lot of shoujo manga. And she's reading manga constantly, so... Yeah, I should try and read more. Anyway, I've done a Google search for that so I can remember to check it out after. What's it about? I think Oran High School Host Club was the first one that I read in that genre. Many, many years ago in college. I also enjoyed the Haruhi light novels that kind of... says a lot about how much of a weeb I used to be. I had all of them at one point as they were coming out. Banana Fish is good. Emotions in people go rampant and then they get infected by frogs. Interesting. You got me thinking now, what else do I read? I literally haven't got any anymore. I would usually have some on the shelf down there. That's cool. It just seemed to take up so much space that I would rather use to film with games, so I decided to get rid of it all. But I appreciate it. I did enjoy having a collection. Wow. That's pretty cool. What are some of your favourite series then? I was friends with someone at uni who had a massive manga collection, and his wardrobe was just filled with books. No clothes or anything, just stacks and stacks of manga. Which is really cool. But yeah, if you've got any more recommendations of things like Bakuman or Genshiken, then I would definitely be interested in reading some. Because I've got my iPad Mini that I love reading on. I've been considering putting some manga on there as well. I just use it for ebooks and magazines, basically. But let's see, actually. I think I've got a manga reader on here. Let's see if there's actually anything saved on there. There is nothing saved on there. And it's one of them annoying ones that's full of adverts, because the one I actually used to like using got taken off the App Store. Which is always really annoying. And then you have to find new sources for all of them and stuff. Yeah, Manga Rock, that's what I used to use. No, I haven't got any on this new one, unfortunately. It looks like something has been dug up from a hole here. The door won't budge at all. I don't think I've got anything to put in there. Fabricant 100. I'll do a search for that so I can remember to look that one up as well. I think this might be the end of me fighting two of these at once. Well, I'm trying to fight him. There was a manga I really enjoyed. I've just found the name of it. It's called Brynhilda in the Darkness. It was kind of like a sci-fi story from what I remember. I don't know whether you've heard of that one. And I saw the anime of that as well back in the day. But yeah, my memory of the past 10 years is pretty much non-existent. I was trying to think what the last actual show I watched was when it was new, and I think it was Golden Time, and I'm pretty sure that came out in 2013 or 14. So, yeah, ever since I left uni and got a job, I kind of just stopped watching anime altogether. Sadly. Yeah, that's it. Goku Koku no Brynhilda. I can't remember much about it, but I remember thinking it had a really cool atmosphere. It kind of reminded me of the game Fragile Dreams, that sort of same style, which I really like. There were some series that I've tried to watch since then, but I keep falling off it for whatever reason. I really wanted to try and watch Little Busters, because I'm a huge fan of Key's earlier work, but I really can't get into Little Busters, and I don't know what it is about it, but It just seems boring. I don't know what people see in it, unless it gets good later on. But I just could not get into it. I was thinking about doing a video on Fragile Dreams at some point. Yeah, Little Busters is on the Switch as well, yeah. I think it started as a visual novel and then it branched out into everything else, as they do. Same as Kynad and Canon and all the other ones. There was one that they made after that called Charlotte, which was anime only, but I didn't enjoy that one either and I dropped about halfway through. Oh, I loved Kynad when I first saw it. And the game. Well, visual novel. What about Steins Gate? Have you ever played or read that? Or watched it? That's one of my favourites. Hey, Cold Fuse, welcome to the stream. Oh, yeah, some people can't get past the art style. If you can overlook the fact that their eyes are melting off the side of their face, then there's a really nice story underneath it. Yeah, you need to check out Steins Gate. It's so cool. It takes a bit of time to get into the story, but once it does, it's a really engrossing tale. Lots of time travel goodness, which I really like. Oh my god, how can you possibly concentrate on three people at once? I hope you haven't got the sound on for all three. That would send you crazy. Who else are you watching? Who's my competition? Not really, I'm not in competition with anyone. I don't really take this streaming seriously. It's YouTube that I'm taking seriously. This is just for fun. There's two different versions of it on the Switch. There's Steins Gate and Steins Gate Elite. So Elite's kind of different. It actually takes scenes from the anime, which is really interesting. So give that one a go. It's kind of a cool mix of both. There's not even anything up here. And there's also Steins Gate Zero as well, which is a prequel that I started playing on the Switch. No, I think I actually started it on the Vita. A friend, and a randomer. Three friends streaming simultaneously. Oh dear. What are they streaming? Are they playing games too? I do have all three physically, but I've got two on the Vita and I've only got Steins Gate Elite on the Switch. So I don't know whether Zero and the regular Steins Gate have physicals or not. And I think it was limited run as well, so I don't know if you'll really be able to pick it up today or not. But they're really good on the Vita, so if you've got Vita, you can pick them up on there. So what VN are you playing now then, at the minute? I haven't got my Switch games up here anymore, so I can't show you. I was playing one on the Switch, can't remember what it was called now. Grisaia, Fruits of Grisaia. But man, it was so slow. I got about 30 hours in and it still felt like nothing had really happened. Again, I really liked the atmosphere and stuff of it, but it just didn't really grip me. And that was like the first game in a series of like three games on that collection and then another three that have come out since. And it just became a bit daunting. Right, I'm going to try and turn these ones into money, or some of them at least. Just be prepared to spend like 200 hours on Grisaia if you do ever plan on getting it. And there was another one that I got off Limited Run recently, which I've been more interested in playing because it's about a group of girls who start a game development studio. And I can't remember what it's called off the top of my head. Let's see if I can find out. It was something that Limited Run like had on their sale thing. So,
reveal to us thy heroic form.
Let's see if I can find it while she's doing this. Hey, you can get the Con Ed visual novel on the Switch as well, if you were ever tempted. Oh, that was useless. The Google link just took me back to the main page. Oh, I can't remember what it was called. Trying to find it on Google Images now, but it is not here. Remaster, reafter, something like that. There it is. It's called Yume Utsusu Remaster and Reafter. So, there you go. It has a really nice front cover. That's the main reason I wanted it, just because I really love the art style. But it does sound like a story that I'd really enjoy too. I don't even know if anything's happening when I merge two of the same type. It's going to increase his defense by one, increase his magic by two. I suppose it's worth doing.
O magical beasts who serve us, merge thy flesh to gain yet greater power. Reveal to us thy heroic form.
I'm trying to think what else I've got in terms of visual novels. I've got Chaos Head, which I haven't played yet. I've heard that's really good, or really a psychological thriller, I think. But unfortunately, I've got that on the PS4, and I don't really know how I feel about playing a visual novel on the TV. It feels like visual novels should be handheld. I don't know why I feel that way, but that's I just feel like that's comfier. Although at uni I would always play them on the PC. Yeah, there we go. We've got three level 5 monsters. I would love to get a Steam Deck, because then that sort of opens up your options for visual novels a lot more. And there's definitely a lot of PC-only ones that I want to play. I want to play whatever the new key game is. Summer Pockets, is it? It came out a few years ago. I keep telling myself, in the summer, I'm going to play Summer Pockets, and then the summer comes and goes. But, not this summer, then. Maybe next summer. And then next summer comes and goes. And then I get more and more busy with my job and YouTube and friends and family. And it's like, I don't know if I can ever play a visual novel again. It's kind of sad. I miss having unlimited free time, like at uni. I played Con Ed for about 200 hours at uni. It's bad. Well, not at the time. I maxed out all like 10 pages of save slots on that game. It was insane. And then, because it hadn't officially come out in English and I was just playing a fan translation, I actually got as far as the translation had got, and then it all just went into Japanese, so I could never actually finish the after story side anyway. Which is really sad. I can't really remember what else I would play visual novel wise. I had a friend who was obsessed with a visual novel called White Album, if you've heard of that one. I think it was by Leaf. I think it's actually got an official release now, recently. Like in the past few months. So maybe that's something I could try out at some point. That'd be cool to play on the Steam Deck, maybe. Hey, we got a raid! Gone mad trying! Wow! Look at all the emojis everywhere. Woo! Hello, everyone! And thanks, Gone Mad Trying. I appreciate that. How's everyone doing? Hey, going well. Having a geeky discussion with Flaming Krieg about visual novels and manga. So, anyone that's just joined from Gone Mad Trying, do you have any favourite manga or visual novels or anime? Yeah, have a look for White Album. It's very highly rated. And, yeah, like I was obsessed with Conad, my friend at uni was obsessed with White Album. As far as I know, it's just a generic romance story. I didn't really know much about it. But he could speak and read Japanese, so he didn't need to wait for a fan translation. Lucky him. There was also a whole bunch of random demos that I downloaded off Manga Gamer and Just USA or wherever the other place was. So I definitely played a lot of them back in the day. But recently, yeah, I haven't played any recently. Ooh, let's see what this magic does. I have to be careful not to actually kill these creatures, because the idea is to try and catch them. Gone Mad Trying, have you got any favourite manga or anime? Right, let's swap back. I feel like I'm not getting anywhere this stream. Let's try and capture. Do you think we'll do that with 16 HP? Are you more just into gaming rather than any other manga anime stuff? I used to be a lot more into it, but I've kind of not got the time to split my attention between like four different things anymore. There is quite a bit of crossover, but it was honestly thanks to a bunch of friends at school and then college after that kind of convinced me to start watching anime back in the day. Things like Haruhi, Gurren Lagann, like mid-2000s stuff like that is what really got me into it. Right, let's try and whittle his health down a little bit more. I thought I said they were level 8 then, they're only level 3. Let's try again. I don't think I picked up any herbs again, did I? I really wish you could skip this bit. It's so slow. But we got him. Swap out to one of the creatures to save me a little bit of health, even though I don't know whether that's the best thing to do. I don't really know. That takes up a lot of mana just to do one little attack. What's everyone else been playing recently? You been playing any fun games? I've been mostly playing Pikmin 4 when I'm not working on videos. And I finished it, and now I'm onto the post-game stuff. And there's a really, really cool surprise. I won't spoil it for anyone. But I was very, very happy and excited. And it got me even more excited for Pikmin 1 and 2 when I get the physical in September at some point. I just realised I'm kind of off the side of the screen a bit there, aren't I? Let's bring that down a bit. That's better. Now I can slouch and you can still see me. I'm going to try and 100% it as well. I'm close. I've 100%ed everything up until this point, actually. But then, yeah, there's all the extra stuff after the credits, which I was not expecting, so still got all that to do. I was so happy, though. Eternal Ring. That's one of the... is that a launch game? I remember it being very early in the PS2's life. Is it an RPG, or is it that sort of multi-genre hybrid game? I can picture the box art, but I've never played it. I've probably got it, actually, up there somewhere. Can't see from here. Yeah, I think my friend at school had it, and he said it was okay. Like, it's interesting the way it mixes the genres. Probably impressive for the time. A game I really want to get for the PS2 soon is Dark Cloud or Dark Chronicle. I've heard they're really good. And I've also been thinking about playing Jade Cocoon 2 as well, after playing this one. But I've heard that Jade Cocoon 2 takes some weird... a weird direction compared to this one, so I'm not really sure whether I would actually like it or not. And I'm not really sure... there we go. At least they're healed. Not really sure where I'm supposed to be going, though. Doesn't look like there's anything to do there until I've got something to put in that pedestal. And I've already been here, and there isn't anything... There isn't anything here. There was just a slab that told me about how to use magic. Which I would hope by this point in the game you would already know how to do anyway. I wish there was a fast forward button, but you don't get that on original hardware. And I'm playing this the hard way. Yeah, I've heard that about Alundra 2 as well. I haven't played the second one either for exactly the same reason. But the first one's great. Although I remember it being very difficult. I can't remember. Maybe I just wasn't so good at games back then. Alundra was a recommendation from someone at college. And I think I borrowed it off him to begin with. And I thought it was awesome. But there should be more 2D games for the PS1. Because Alundra looks really cool too. I love that style. Like, if a 32-bit 2D Zelda game existed, that's what it would look like. There was the same on the Sega Saturn as well, with one of the Shining games. Shining Wisdom, I think it's called. That's something I've been thinking about playing soon too. But yeah, Alundra 2 went all 3D and weird, didn't it? Just like a dungeon crawler. But I've never actually played it. I've seen screenshots and I've seen people online complaining about it. So it kind of put me off. You did it in 40 hours. Is that good or bad? I don't know how long it's supposed to be. Oh yeah, I remember. There was some awkward platforming. Not as bad as... What's that Mega Drive game that's isometric? Story of Thor? No, I'm thinking of something else. There's one really famous sort of action RPG for the Mega Drive that's isometric, and it has horrible jumping mechanics. I suppose any isometric game does, really, doesn't it? Can I go under there? Is that where I'm supposed to be going? No. Okay, let's try going back on ourselves and take a different path. We're supposed to be going down there, maybe. How do I get under this bridge? Go left here? No. Wow, 10 hours of failing to jump. Apparently this is quite a short RPG, but I'm really not making any progress. Maybe it's just a short RPG for people who actually know what they're doing. Because I think I'm going to die again now. Oh, I do actually have some attacks, but I should probably save those for a boss fight. If there is one. I need to go back and buy some health, I think. Buy some herbs or potions or whatever this game equivalent is. Hey, maybe we can catch him. One more hit. Come on. I'm going to attempt it now. If he doesn't kill me. Oh no! I just thought I'd made it. Oh well. The camera's all lopsided. That's better. Yeah, now you can see me properly. I think. Anyway, let's go back and get some money. Should we make a save, as we haven't saved yet? So, I think what we need to do is go here, make some silk that you can then turn into money, and then go to the shop. A lot of back and forth in this game. Why do we have to read that every single time? Ooh, there is a new one, though. Should we... Let's merge these two together. So we should have earth and air and a better attack, if I'm reading that right.
Oh, magical beasts who serve us.
We can listen to
merge
her this time.
Thy flesh to gain yet greater power. Reveal to us thy heroic form.
I really enjoyed the start of this game when you're going around in this town for the first time and it's introducing you to the backstory and stuff, but since then, once you've gone into the dungeons, it doesn't really seem like there's that much to do. And just so I know that this is a new creature. Oh, actually, as I was naming these after people in the chat last time, let's go up and call this one. However much a flaming Krieg can fit. You can't go off one side of the keyboard and onto the other. Flaming Cry. That's as far as I can make it. So I don't know if you're supposed to keep going, like, I don't know what I'm looking at here. Results. Which bit am I looking at? The second part? The first part? Like, where do they fit on this list? I don't understand. Am I going to be making that second one in at the top if I merge these two together now? I really don't understand where I'm supposed to look here. Or how you're meant to know. Because I can't merge two of them because only one exists. So that's saying I'll get one extra defense. And it'll be level 4. Oh well, let's do it. Let's see what happens. I'm just guessing, honestly, at this point. It's done. And we'll give him the same name. Yeah, he's level 4 now. Oh, cool. And if I do it with this one, he'll become level 5 and everything will go up. Let's do that. You're supposed to be looking at the design of the monsters as well, because they change depending on what you merge with what. So maybe I should actually check what they look like. So that should be a really strong one now. And there's still one more I can merge it with. Although that won't do anything, maybe because it's not high enough level. Anyway, if you press circle, then you can see what they look like. He's just a little green thing with a giant horn. I don't even know how to explain him. So, level 5, attack 31, defense 29. He's actually the strongest one I've got. Awesome. Sorry, the Ginger W. You've been replaced. So, if there's anything left, I can actually turn these into money. Maybe I'll get more money because that one was a powered up one.
Oh, warrior of justice, return to whence thee came, to the place of Elrum. Grant us our daily bread.
I'm not going to be buying bread with it. I'm going to be buying a sword. My daily sword. You can get money by selling this sunk at the shop. I don't know how much you gave me. Hopefully it's not just two pieces. Okay, let's head off to the shop. To the town shop. I think the blacksmith can buy it from you as well, but we want to go to the shop anyway to get some potions. Hey, wake up. Oh, they don't want to do voice acting for him? Hey, how's it going, Mr. Cocoon Master? It's going to be tough battling demons and all. Me, well, I have it hard, but not nearly as bad as you. My father is always away, so my mum never leaves me alone. She's just lonely. It's great that she loves me at all, but jeez, have you ever been smothered like that? I always am. Oh yeah, you came to do some shopping. Poor guy, his mum won't leave him alone. Oh cool, we got 6 pieces. It gives us 900 yen? Yan? 900 yan. I think 900 yen is enough. What else can we buy? What does that do? Poison antidote. Cures bleeding and reduces fever. I don't know which one of these I need. I'm guessing this one. Let's buy 5 of that. 10 of that. And I'm presuming we had to get some of that one as well. And I can't remember what that does. That revives. Let's get 3 more of them to make that an even 10. Hey, while you were gone taking the trash out, I named one of the monsters after you. Ah, I'm so bored and there hasn't been any customers today. Maybe I'll go to the square to hear some stories. Have we been to the square? Let's go there, see if anyone knows there. He looks like a green dragon with a giant horn. Or he used to. Here he is. It wouldn't quite fit, so your name's Flaming Cree. Oh, you can't see it on here? What's the point of having it on there if you're not allowed to see what it looks like? Well, next time we're in a fight, I'll get it out anyway. There's only them 2 people there anyway. Why bother telling me to go to the town square? Anyway, we are now stocked up with potions and antidotes and all sorts of things. So let's head back into the dragonfly forest. And try and go in a different way because I reached the end of the path last time and there wasn't anything there. Well, there was. There was a hole in the floor. The backgrounds are so detailed, sometimes it's hard to see where you're actually supposed to go. I think this is the only way you can go at the moment. Kind of reminds me of Myst having all these pre-rendered backgrounds. So I'm hoping to be able to go down here and then go under the bridge that I walked over last time. Good question. I don't know. The 2 areas that I've been to so far are jungle. Well, one of them was kind of a foresty area, and this bit is more of a bigger jungle theme. I don't know what the other areas are like yet. Here we go. I can bring you out. You're actually the strongest monster I've got now. You've got over 100 hit points. And attack of 30 compared to 26 for the one that I replaced you with. There you go. Like a green dragon thing, and you've got a fire attack, an earth attack. If we attack him with a fire attack, that should be super effective. Yeah, look at you go. And good defense as well. Let's try doing that again. It does take up a lot of mana though, so that's pretty much all used up now on that one. On that Trialco. Not like Trico. Should we try one regular attack? Hey, that's not fair. He got 2 hits in. Don't kill him. That's it, now we can catch him. We can say your monster's been working out then. There we go, capture. We can definitely capture him now. Slowly gaining experience. Very slowly. Now, is there any way to get on there? Oh my god, auto mod! Auto mod is going crazy. You are allowed to say you'll hit me up. Just don't threaten me. Yeah, hit me up on Twitter, sure thing. Or X, I guess you should say these days. No one says that though. I really need to tone down Automod. I didn't know that he was so sensitive. I only put it on because I had some people spamming their like shops and things that I didn't want. But now he's gone a bit crazy with power. Because I didn't think it was worth having any actual mods yet, because I don't really get enough viewers or chats to justify having one, really. I wouldn't want to burden anyone with having to be on every stream for the off chance that something might happen, very rarely. I mean, it makes sense on Discord, but not on here. I need someone to go through my YouTube comments, because I get some right idiots on there after it leaves my regular viewership. Oh, what's the link on there? It might be my old one, I did have to rename it recently. Let me see if I can change it. It should be Retro Break Nick. That's what I use now. Is it connections? Profile? Do I have to go into the account to change it? Oh my god, now I can hear myself. Oh yeah, that's my old account. It's going to Retro Break Games. Where do I go? Create a dashboard, maybe? Oh yeah, there it is. Change that to Retro Break Nick. There you go. If you refresh now, it should be fixed. Retro Break Games was my old account when I thought I wanted to make games. But then I thought it didn't make sense having two different ones, so I deleted it. I'm gonna run from these guys. I still can. Well, make games. I did try recently. I was making a game with a group of friends for a game jam, but everyone got really busy and we all had to put it aside. I was quite enjoying it, and now that I understand programming as well, I feel like I can make things a lot faster than I could a few years ago, which is promising. It was going to be a Metroidvania where you play as a mouse called Bow, and I was programming the bow and arrow physics, and you would get different upgrades for the arrow that allow you to manipulate and move around the environment differently. It was a cool idea. What kind of game is she making? And what engine too? I did make a platformer game ages ago called Super Donuts, which I was really, really happy about. But I had to take it off all the stores because it wasn't making any sales. And it was costing me to keep hosting it, and then the program broke that I'd built it in, so I couldn't update it for the new phones and stuff, and it just became a nightmare to keep on top of. Visual novel slash rhythm RPG. Interesting. Is it at the state where she's sharing anything from it? I'd like to take a look. Unity's a good engine for someone who's new to game development. There's loads of tutorials out there and stuff, so it's a great one to pick up. That's what we were making Bow in as Unity. And because I know C# now, I could pick it up quite easily. Look at you go, Flaming Cree, taking all these guys out, no trouble. Yeah. Send me a DM on there if you want. Or do I need to be following you first? Let's see. Flaming Krieg. 666, is that it? Gristle Brand 666. There you go, mate. I've followed you back. So feel free to DM me. Maybe I can give her some advice as well. If there's anything she's stuck on. Are you not interested in doing any programming or development at all? Or art or anything? What would your specialty be if you were making a game? I'm definitely on the development, design and programming side of things. I'm terrible at art. Well, I'm not terrible. The whole reason I got the pencil for the iPad Mini is so that I could practice doing some drawings, but I didn't really have much. I haven't really dedicated much time to drawing anything. Let's see if I've got anything on here that I can show. I'd love to be like a all-rounder, capable of doing art and design and everything. I've been doing some sketches, like there's the... Oh wow, that's way too bright. Let's see if I turn it down like that, maybe? No, it's too dark. There's the GDQ mascot, if you can see him. Just about. And I started drawing Sonic in his Sonic Adventure form. And what else have I got on here? A basic Miku. It really doesn't want to focus, does it? There you go. And just a few random sketches. I should put some more time into drawing because I do enjoy it. And it's actually quite nice drawing on the iPad. I didn't expect it to feel as good as it does, really. And it's easier than drawing with pen or pencil because you can easily rub it out and you can have a reference on the screen as well, which is pretty fun. I can never decide what to focus on, honestly. I want to learn how to do everything. I want to learn how to play an instrument as well. My dad said he's got a MIDI keyboard in the loft and he's going to get it down for me at some point so I can have it here and practice. I would love to do covers of game soundtracks and stuff. Maybe I could have a separate YouTube channel. The only thing I can slightly play is the guitar. I had some lessons as a teenager, but I didn't really get that far with it. What about anyone watching or listening? Can any of you play any instruments? I was playing around with a program called Ableton as well to make some music on the computer recently, which was fun. But again, I don't know where to spend my time. Should I dedicate... I've already been here. Should I dedicate all my time to learning how to make better videos? Should I try other things like making games? Learning how to grow my streaming, maybe? I don't know. I don't know where to focus. I want to write a book as well. I don't know how that fits into everything. And obviously I want to do well enough at work so that I can still be paid and continue to pursue all these hobbies, which is definitely important. Hey, we found him. We found someone. He looks like one of the guys in the town square.
Well, what do we
a
have
A poacher.
Here? Aren't you a little young to be a cocoon master? So, you're a fake too, huh?
Why does it sound like he's talking into a
Get
can or something?
Get fly cocoon somewhere else. This is my turf. You think you're better than me, huh? Well, you leave me no choice.
Hey, I didn't know you'd sent me a message back in when was that? September 22? I'm sorry, I wasn't ignoring you. I don't think I see messages from people that I don't follow. Oh no, we have to fight the poacher. Let's bring him back out. Scrap Metal Saints, upcoming free-to-play visual novel fully developed by Vampire Arts. Oh wow, that looks really cool. Only 4 posts? Tell her she needs to advertise it more. Looks cool though, kind of reminds me of Clax, except with a giant demon. It doesn't say what element he is. Let's try an earth attack. That didn't do too badly, although he's just disappeared. No, she shouldn't feel bad for advertising. Especially not on a dedicated page for it. Like, that's what it's there for. If you feel bad about advertising on your own account, then yeah, having a separate page for it is the right idea. I don't want to kill him. Let's swap to this one. I had a separate page for Super Donuts when I was making that. And then if people want to follow, then that's up to them, isn't it? What is this? Why are we fighting a goat now? What's happened? I don't even know what that magic does. It didn't seem to do anything. How is that fair? You got 2 attacks in, and I didn't get to do anything. At least we're making some progress. I need someone with water, really. I should really read the description. Earth attack, 1 enemy. Extra damage versus water. Higher earth element ratio yields more damage. I doubt it's going to do much good. I didn't do anything. Oh no. Do I need to try and find a water monster? Earth against fire doesn't seem like a good thing. She's been learning the guitar thanks to you, that's cool. It's always good when you've got a partner who can help you learn new stuff. The whole reason I picked up drawing is because Sarah's an artist. And we've been thinking about making a game together for a long time as well. We kind of had plans on and off for making a modern, updated version of Mischief Makers. Trying to recreate all of the gameplay mechanics in Unity. Which could be a fun challenge. I think I was trying to figure it out in my head. I think I know how to program all the stuff in that game now. Like shaking things and having different effects happen and stuff. Let's heal you back up to full health. She actually started playing it on stream recently. As part of a Steam stream train thing that she was part of. Replaying Mischief Makers. And we were happy to find out that some people on the stream used to really love the game too. So it's great to find out that people know about it. Give us that Mischief Makers remake. Maybe one day. Maybe I'll actually try and focus on that soon. I think it'd be a fun challenge. Trying to think of all the different things you do in that game, because pretty much every level has a different mechanic to it. Like there's a bit where you're on a bike, then there's a bit when you're on that giant block man and you have to push his arms from side to side to move through the minefield section. There's so much going on in that game. I wonder whether I can catch this or not. Do you think it's worth trying to swap back? Let's do one more attack. Okay, let's try. Yeah, you should revisit it. It's such a fun game. And like I said, every level is completely different. And then you have the weird Olympics bit in the middle of it, just thrown in there for good measure. And all the boss fights are really cool too. And then you have to try and beat all the bosses without getting hit. Oh, I'm not allowed to capture him. Where's the fun in that? Yeah, you have to do all the boss fights without getting hit and then get the gems to make the ending longer. That's something else I would have to figure out how to program, like how to keep track of how many gems you'd picked up in the stage and use that to affect the ending. And getting the physics right and the controls would be difficult. It was a really interesting control scheme where you got like all the C buttons dash in different directions and then you can double tap to use thrusters and things. It's just a really cool game. I'm just going to keep hitting him like this. I think I'll be okay. Yeah, I'll be fine. Maybe. Not if he does two. Why is he allowed to do two at once? I'm never allowed to do two. One more hit, maybe? I'll be fine as long as he hasn't got some sort of special attack up his sleeve. Okay, one more after this. Here we go. Die, poacher. Uppercut. Bum, bum, bum.
Ow! I'll get you for that.
Is that it? You're not going to explain why you were there or what's going on or anything? I got a key. Lava key. And magic usage 2 tablet. Do I follow him or keep going around? Is there anything else over there? I guess I go down here then. Shall we see what magic tablet 2 said? Magic usage 2. Your elemental attack power is related to the amount of elemental properties you have. That is just gobbledygook. Didn't make any sense to me whatsoever. Now where are we going? Is that going around in a circle? Yeah. Well, I got a key. Can I use it on that door that I was stuck at before, maybe? Are you water? Should I try and catch him? Two water creatures. Awesome. We can use this one. I think air is weak against water because it's opposite. Maybe. Let's see if this actually does anything. No. Is it poison? Foot. What does foot do? Am I going to kick them? It didn't do much. Oh no. They're going to kill me now. Don't feel bad about not having enough time to work on your own personal project. That's always the case. You just have to use whatever spare time you've got in between whatever life throws at you. Even if that's just like half an hour a day, it's better than doing nothing at all. Hey, I actually mentioned Bo earlier. Not to put you on the spot or anything, Karna. But come on, when are we going to program that bow animation? One year, right? Let's restart it for the next game jam. I'm nearly dead again. Let's heal back up. Oh yeah, that's cool. It looked good from what you showed me already. Have you got much left to finish up on it? Oh, speaking to you guys has really made me want to try and make something again now. I want to try and work on that Mischief Makers remake. I think it'd be a really fun programming challenge. More fun than what I'm programming at work, right? To make a search center to surface documents from different libraries. How fun. Player choices, documentation and tutorial. Awesome. Mischief Makers. It's an interesting platformer slash weird mix of genres game for the Nintendo 64. One of Sarah's favourite games. And we were talking about making a remake of it together. There's loads of really weird mechanics. Like, you pick the enemies up and you shake them. And depending on what enemy it is or what item it is, it has different effects that happen. Like, you can shake a jar and depending what's inside it, it could throw you out a different item or something, or you shake a block and then it shoots you into the air and stuff. So there's all sorts of weird things that I would have to learn how to program, but it'd be a good challenge. Yeah, I think remaking a game is a good way of learning too, isn't it? A lot of game tutorials and stuff say start with like an old arcade game and learn how to make that before moving on to something bigger. Right, let's switch back and we can capture this water one now. And that'll be the first water monster that I've got. Should be able to capture him fine. And hopefully where I think I'm going is where I need to use the key. Yeah, when you come down for the barbecue, we can discuss some of your other projects and ideas too. And how about the YouTube channel? How's that going? Have you made any progress on that? True. But at least you've got ideas. You just need to get some processes in place and get some systems set up that make it easier to actually work on stuff. It is difficult. It took me a long time to be able to make weekly videos. Like, I had to get the setup exactly right so that I can just press record and get it all done without having to plug anything else in, or, you know, having the lights all set up on a button and stuff. So many things. Oh no! Is that taking up all your free time? That's the other thing you have to do, is not get distracted by new game releases. Hence why I still haven't finished Tears of the Kingdom. But yeah, have some sort of system in place so you know, like, on this day of the week I'm going to do this little bit, this little thing, and then, so for me, Tuesday is streaming night, Wednesday is record video, Thursday is edit video, Friday's upload video, and then Saturday, Sunday, Monday is write the script for the week after. And that is the sort of flow that I've got myself into, and I feel like it works quite well. But it took me a long time to be able to actually do that in that set amount of days. I don't think I'm going to be able to fight all three of these. Is it going to let me run? No. Ah, what a waste of a turn. And I'm going to die again. Ah, so annoying. What do I use to edit? I use Final Cut Pro on my M1 MacBook. And I used to use Premiere, but I found that very frustrating to use. And honestly, I think it's because of Final Cut that I'm actually able to get the edit done in, like, one evening or two evenings. Whereas with Premiere, it would have taken me all week. Because I've got some really good templates that I've built over the years, and like, I can just drag the files into the right place. And then I've got all the audio levels set and stuff. So it took a lot of tinkering, but I'm happy with where it is now. And I found a really cool program called Post Haste, which allows you to type in the name of the project, and then it uses a like project folder that you've got set up in the background, so there's always an exact replica. So I've got like B-roll, A-roll, gameplay footage, script, editing template, Patreon names. They're all already there every time I hit go or generate or whatever for the project, which has made everything a lot easier and a lot faster. So yeah, I had to get all these things set up in order to make everything. And then I use GarageBand to record the audio, and I've got all the levels set up properly on there and stuff. Premiere Pro is just clunky, and it kept breaking. And rendering would take forever. I mean, maybe it's better now. The last time I used it was 2015. And then I bought an iMac and thought I would try out Final Cut instead. And I found that a lot more easier to use. Although that's not why I bought the Mac. I bought it to be able to make iPhone games. And then that didn't really happen. Well, I made two games. And then they just sort of died. And then I took up video editing and video making and stuck with that instead. Which I find a lot more rewarding, honestly. Flaming Krieg, you're gonna die. I'm sorry. He's gone. I don't think Phoenix Down exists. You'd have to edit that. I guess it depends how complicated the system is to use. You could probably do that in a short. That could work. That'd be good advertising for it as well. Sorry. I don't think there's any way of bringing you back. I can try this, actually. Attack every enemy with fire. Let's see how much damage this does. Well, it got rid of one of them. Where are you going to upload the code to? Is it going to be part of the Unity store? And then are you going to put the guide on your YouTube channel and send people to the store to download it? On the asset store, yeah. That's a cool idea. Hopefully you can revive the monsters when you go back to the town. I hope so. Because it's a pain to actually get them up to that level, so I hope he's not dead forever. $5 for the module? That sounds reasonable. You can use it to fund Bo, but I think we're all capable, we need time. So unless you can fund us all to quit our jobs and work on it full time, I don't really know what you'll be able to do. If you feel like paying me with your Unity Asset Store money to quit my job, then go for it. Morale boosting events. Yeah, we could have like a in-person brainstorming session or something. Or a programmer's afternoon get-together. That'd be cool. I actually used to do something like that at uni when we were making games in Unreal. We would have days where we'd just go to each other's houses and just go through, you know, whatever gameplay system we were trying to make that day and flesh it out in person. It is a lot easier because you've got people to bounce ideas off. I don't even know what this attack does. I've never even read into it. It does 5 points of damage. Whatever use that is. Now all my monsters are dead. Yeah, I think once the deadline for the game jam was coming up and we realized how far behind we were, everyone sort of lost interest in it. And then I know some people went on holiday, and then me and Sarah had Comic Cons to prepare for, so I can see why everyone stopped working on it, but hopefully we can get back into it at some point. Yeah, even something fun like that. We could all meet up in Birmingham for an evening or something. We can all take laptops to the karaoke bar and work on it in there. It's a shame there isn't any, like, gaming co-working spaces you can go to, because I know someone in Sweden, maybe? Switzerland? Somewhere like that, anyway. He makes game assets and he's used the money from that to actually fund a game development space where just the general public can come and, like, use the computers that are there with all these programs on and stuff. And, like, students use it and people who are working on indie games come in and use it. I just think it sounds so cool. But I don't think anything like that exists in the UK. But I think it'd be cool, because then you've got, like, other people also working on similar projects that you can bounce ideas off and get feedback from things and learn from people and stuff. Whereas you don't really get that from home, and I feel like it's kind of the same at work as well. Although I do enjoy working from home, you kind of miss getting the back and forth of people working on things, don't you? A little bit. Maybe you can use your asset store money to set up a game dev space. Yeah. I've only had pretty bad experiences with the office, honestly, in my old job. It was just middle-aged people who just did not care about the work at all. Like, from where I was sitting, I could see some lady just looking at holiday sites all day and not actually doing anything. Oh, it was so bad. And then there was this new hire that had come in and he was so bored. I could see him just flicking through screens on the calendar for hours. Oh my god, why are you even here? It's so demoralizing. But the team I'm in now is really cool. I'm working with a really good developer. Except it's not for making fun things, it's for making document management solutions. But it's kind of cool because we're building it from scratch, so we kind of get a say in the development of it. Yeah, so we're making a program which links in with housing management software so that people can store different documents of different types using their system, and it'll go into a specific place online. And then today I was building a search center that can look through all the document libraries and pull things together, so if they search on a ID number or a case ID or something, it can find all the files related to that and surface them. So it's pretty boring stuff, but at least we get a say in the development of it. I'm getting to work with Power Apps soon. I'm making a front end, a dynamic front end, so it can check in the Azure directory to see who's looking at it and surface all the groups that they're supposed to be part of. So there's some pretty interesting stuff. Cool, thanks for joining anyway. And tell your girlfriend what she's done on the game so far. Looks really good. Actually, for some motivation, I'll give her a follow as well. And tell her, don't be worried about sharing updates on Twitter. There you go. And I gave her a follow on her art account as well. Capture! We can get him. Had fun talking. Thanks again for wanting to follow. Appreciate it. Hopefully when travelling to the UK I'll get to meet you. Yeah, hopefully. Maybe you can time it for one of the events that I'll be at. Maybe Play Expo next year. It'd be cool to do a meetup at some point as well, now I'm getting bigger on YouTube. I was thinking one day I could like rent out arcade club in Manchester or something for the evening. That could be fun. Or have a meetup at one of the gaming events would be cool too. I'm going to Insomnia in September. I don't know whether you'll be able to get over there for then. But anyway, I'll let you go. Thanks for joining. Yeah, see if you come. See if you can make it. It's in Birmingham in middle of September. I've got some press passes, so I'll be there to film the event, which will be fun. I've never been to it before, either. Yeah, see you, mate. Have a good one. Yeah, we both got press passes, which is great because the regular tickets for the weekend were like 90 quid each or something. Oh no, she got denied. That's not fair. Did they give a reason why? She was there last year as a creator, but this year they said no. That's not fair. No reason either. Maybe it's because... No, I don't really know. I can't remember what they asked. Did they ask what you were planning to record from the event or anything? Because does she make videos or is she just VTube? Because maybe they want more in-person stuff. Maybe. Oh. No idea then. Try again next year, I guess. I've applied for EGX as well, so I'm waiting to hear back from them. Maybe she could try that in London in October, I think that is. 14th of October. What? Going out there didn't heal anything. Do I have to go all the way back? Okay, looks like we've got to go all the way back to my house and heal everyone up. Did you go to Insomnia last year? Is it any good? I've heard good things about it, but I've never actually attended it. Not even when it was here in Telford, years and years ago. Oh, cool. It was small. No, they made it look really big in the pictures. I used to love going to EGX when that was in Birmingham, but it's moved to London now. It's kind of hard to get to. I wouldn't pay 90 quid. Yeah, it doesn't sound worth it. It's insane how expensive it is. I guess the main thing is that if you take your own computer, then you can spend the night doing all the LAN stuff. London Comic Con's like 80 or 90 as well now. Everything's going up. But obviously I always get into that for free because Sarah's always got her table there. How do I actually heal? I don't know. We were thinking about doing some Comic Cons abroad as well, because someone we were speaking to, Anime Con in Birmingham, said they do one in Germany that's really good. So it might be fun to venture out a bit and do some abroad. Let's see, what can we do? Can we make a water / fire? We can make a water and earth one. Let's try that.
O magical beasts who serve us, merge thy flesh to gain yet greater power. Reveal to us thy heroic form.
I want to at least get to the end of this section in this stream. Although I am very, very slowly making progress. I was told this is a short game. I feel like I'm not getting anywhere. And hey, as we're naming people after people in the stream, this one can be Kana. There you go, now you're officially a monster. Let's see what you look like. There we go, you're some weird blue turtle creature. Yeah, it's I've got the box for it over there. There you go, this is what we're playing. Can you see? Go on camera. Focus. There you go. Jade Cocoon. And there's Skittles down there. I just disturbed his sleep. Apparently a lot of people played a demo of it. It might have come with Final Fantasy or something. But I was recommended this by a friend, Ryan Brown, who says it's one of his favourite games. And I found it in CEX the other day and thought I would give it a try. It seems pretty fun so far. And I'm going to sell. Maybe I can keep merging them actually. Let's make you even stronger. Let's see when it came out. I don't know which one it came with actually.
Merge thy flesh to gain yet greater power.
99. That might have been Final Fantasy 9 then. Let's see if Google can say what it came with. When I posted on YouTube that I was going to play it, a load of people were like, whoa, I played the demo back in the day. It was really fun, but I'd never seen the full game. And it's a cool idea, but it's a very slow-paced game. All I can see is that the demo came with another one of Crave's games called Shadow Madness. I don't know what that game is. Have you ever heard of a game called Shadow Madness for the PlayStation 1? Looks like another RPG. With bad reviews. Whereas this one at least got 8 or 9s. Alright, thanks for dropping by. I'll see you soon. No, I'll be busy working on my video up until Saturday then, so I'll see you then. Unless you watch my video on Friday, then technically you'll see me beforehand. But yeah, looking forward to seeing you.
O magical beasts who serve us, merge thy flesh to gain. Revealed.
Anyone who's still watching, look down there. He's flat out. Can't see through the desk. There we go. If I angle the camera like that, you can see if he wakes up. Oh, that's actually going to make him weaker. And that is. Maybe that's as far as I can go. Level 5, 29, 29. Level 5, 27, 24. Sorry, Sasakento, you're gone. I don't think I actually healed anything though. Still got 14 HP. Oh, I am healed. Excellent. Maybe I can go and see if the blacksmith's got any new gear for me. I doubt it. He's pretty useless. No, nothing new. Nothing new at all. Let's just go back again. No, I don't want to go to the Beetle Forest. I'll go to the Dragonfly Forest. Let's try and speedrun our way back there. Ah, I hate the way the camera spins around there. You have to hold down when you're going in, and then hold up. So, we've got a key that we can use somewhere. Leave me alone. It must be over this bridge because I'm pretty sure I've exhausted every area underneath it. There must be somewhere to use the key. It must be that big door at the end. Here. Or do I use the key in this? Yay, we did it. I thought I was going to need a gem or something to go in there. So that's pretty cool. Then we can move on. We're making progress. Woo! And there's a save point right there. I didn't need to go out. Four hours and 12 minutes. It feels longer than that. I'm sure I streamed for 3.5 hours last time. And I've been streaming for 2 hours today. That should make 6 hours, not 4 hours something. There is a bag filled with sweet smelling powder on the ground. Sleep spores picked up. There's the winged man.
Hey, you're a cocoon Kiffinac. Master, right? What do you say to a quick little duel?
He has a strange voice.
What? You're no fun. Don't you know who I am? Ha! I can't believe it! I am the strongest, most handsome guy in the forest. I go by many names, such as Birdman. After all, I am the
legendary any other names?
Dragonfly Forest. It's hard being so famous. Call me Kiki-Nak. Of course, that's only if you can defeat me. Well, that's all for introductions. Here we go!
Okay, based on that folklore thing that the old man by the tree was telling us in the last episode, I guess, that is not how I expected him to be. Shall we just try and use all of my monsters first and see how much health we can get down? Dun, 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 dun. I don't even know what type he is. Let's see if that does anything. Not bad. Good going, Karna. Although you've lost your horn now. It's see if a regular attack does more damage. About the same. Right, swap him out now while he's still alive. Oh no! Why are they allowed to do two attacks at once sometimes? Play the Song of Sadness. Let's bring out the next one. I don't think I actually named him. He's the only one that's not named after someone. Let's try S. Earth attack plus accuracy. I don't know what plus accuracy helps with. It was a good idea to go and level up these monsters. It's making these boss fights quite easy. Let's try magic. Didn't do much. Level up! Woo! Oh, okay, so you can level up the monsters separately if they win fights, I guess.
Wow, you are so powerful! I've heard the rumors, but Cocoon Masters really are powerful!
I am.
So, you're from Cyrus, huh? Well, now I've met two. If there's anything I can do for you, just ask me. From now on, we're friends.
Come on, ask me something. Okay.
Calabas?
So,
you mean this powder?
This was a herb to bring people back
My
to life,
Yamu
I guess.
From the spider forest gave it to me.
Well, they've been put under a spell and
the
sent to sleep.
The only thing you'll find here in the dragonfly forest is sleep spores. If you want some Calabas, why not go talk to Yamu? Yamu and his family are very fond of rare and unusual things. So if you give them something valuable, just maybe... But I warn you, they're very greedy and won't share with you so easy. Oh yes, you can have this too. Without it, you can't get inside.
A spider key. And what else do you want me to tell me about? Ask about the other person.
What? You haven't heard of him? Well, that's odd. My young friend was bragging so much. You don't know who it is? His name is Kelmar. He is strong, you know. He's my best friend. What? You're friends with him too? Oh, so it's you. The Cocoon Master he was talking about.
Hey!
Well now, it's a small world indeed. Kelmar has told me a lot about you. He said, no one is stronger than me, but strength does not make a powerful man.
I can't remember who Kelmar is.
What he has. Speaking of which, the power of man is so complicated. I just don't get it.
Okay, I don't know whether that helped at all.
Leaving already? Well, take this. It's proof of our friendship.
But at least I'm friends with the weird bird man.
You can have it. We'll be able to meet anytime you use it.
Okay.
I'll tell you about myself next time we meet. Well, see you later.
Great. Just tell me about how great he is. Why does he sound like a pig?
The Unforgiven.
There we go, that's the end of this chapter.
And at times, like a child.
The Sage of the Forest. I suppose we're halfway through the game now, if that's two of the four gates. Maybe? Let's see what happens now.
meet the Birdman?
I did. He was a little strange. Oh, are you not going to say anything? What has transpired? Show the calabash powder.
So, this powder is ground from the leaves of the calabash? We must go report this to the chieftain at once. Although this confirms the existence of the calabash, this is not enough to save the entire village. You have no choice but believe what the Birdman said and venture into the spider forest. There are many types of divine spirits. Know you that some can be quite malicious. If we can believe Kikinok, then it is true that the forest man has become the fallen spirit Mamon, as told in Agi legend. Mamon was an agent of Elrum, drowned in material greed.
He seemed fine to me.
Elrum that he punished Mamon by transforming him into a hideous form. It is said that Mamon was commanded to live the rest of his existence as the keeper of the divine tree. If Kikinok is the divine spirit Amos, who indulged in lust, then Yom, the forest man, must be the divine spirit Mamon, who indulged in greed. Perhaps there is more about Yamu in the folktales of Cyrus. The old gravekeeper Poto may know something. Why not ask him about the folktales? You must go to the spider forest and find Yamu, the forest man. Much treachery lies ahead in the spider forest. Tread carefully.
Let's see what we can do with... Oh!
Huh? Oh,
whoops.
It's nothing.
I missed a bit.
I was just wondering, that's all.
She was asking what my father was like, who is the previous cocoon master. Your minion is wounded. Oh, okay, she can heal them.
Our
excellent.
Enemy we love, and for the tormented
I'll bear that in mind next time, rather than using herbs Krampus, every time.
The beasts of knowledge, the power to touch the spirit.
Okay, everyone's healed up. Is there anything right at the bottom of this list? No. You can fit a lot on the list, though. Let's see. I think I've got to the point now where there's no point in actually merging anyone because they're actually going to lose strength. Oh, unless earth and air, earth, air and fire. What about if I do something like that? Earth and air. If I merge these two together, then I'll make a really strong one. Right? Maybe? Is that how it works? Let's try it. So, SS Kento should be level 7 then.
Beasts who serve us,
I think.
Merge thy flesh to gain yet greater power. Reveal to us thy heroic form.
I'm going to update backloggery while we're doing this. Okay, it's done. Oh, do I have to go on a different menu? Equip. That's it, I have to bring him up here.
It's hard to talk about it with
another cutscene. Cool.
Let's go outside. Go on ahead. I'll be right out.
Okay, should we do that now or leave it till next time? I guess we can do it now. I want to end on a interesting note. Ooh, we get a nice FMV cutscene again. Kind of.
I'm sorry for asking you to come out of your way. It's just that it's hard to talk about things with Mother Garai around. We used to be able to talk about everything. It's strange, isn't it?
Oh, okay. I never know when she's going to ask me a question. She just stops talking.
While you're gone. She's really kind to me, and she might just be worried about me, but I'm sorry, I just can't stand it at all. Mother Garai may understand how she feels, but I sure don't. Purification is nothing but pain. Didn't your mother do it all because she loved your father? And then he just got up and left her because he couldn't stand to watch her suffer? How cruel! But why, even after all of that, does she still love him? Are all women like that? I can't say this in front of Mother Garai, but I really don't agree with that at all. I'm sorry if this upsets you, but I just couldn't live the way she does. No matter what happens,
my disc is a bit scratched.
Don't worry about me. Do your duty as our cocoon master. Just don't run off like your father.
I don't think he meant to.
Your father, he's supposed to be a great man, right? I heard the story of the day he said goodbye to your mother. I heard that he was a kind man who always protected her.
Oh no, the disc's going all jumpy.
But how could such a man leave her? Do you call that kindness? The cursed brandings are a painful experience for a woman. But that's why I need you here with me. To your mom, your father's departure might have been an act of sympathy, but I don't agree. I would have felt betrayed. We're both in this together, so please stay here as the cocoon master of Cyrus. Me? Well, you know I really like you a lot. It's just that there's so much going on right now, you know? Why do we have to have so many rules and traditions? There's no escape. I know some people hate the Nagi, but I'm an individual. I won't run away from them or anything just because it's hard. I might have married you because I had to, but I would never, ever leave you. All we ever talk about now are the village and cocoons, minions. I know now's not the time to be worrying about these kind of things, but it's just that I never get to see you anymore. If only things were different.
She should learn to become a party member and come with me.
I'm sorry. I don't even know what I'm trying to say.
Then I wouldn't have to come back to the village every time I wanted to do something with one of the monsters. Why can't she just come with me?
I almost forgot. Take this. You'll probably need it.
A belt? Are my trousers falling down? Right, I think there is a good place to end it for this stream, so thank you everyone. If anyone's still with me, thank you so much for dropping by tonight. I really had a lot of fun playing this, and hopefully you all had a lot of fun chatting with me.
So,
what can she do? Nothing really, I think I've already been through that. So yeah, thanks everyone for dropping by. I'm going to save now, and then we can pick this up again next Tuesday. I'm glad we actually made some progress in the end. Let's see what my stats are. 4 hours 26, level 7. Alright, thanks everyone. See you all again soon. Goodbye.